Bharatiya Vidhya Bhavans, Atmakuri Rama Rao School, Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad, welcomes you to its sprawling campus through its gate 1. The students enter and exit through the gate 1. Welcoming you to the sprawling campus of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan's Atmakuri Rama Rao School. The school is bestowed with the grace of the presiding deity Sri Vidya Ganapati. The school is guarded by 13 feet high compound wall on the north side of the plot. The entry into the school campus on the left side is the compound wall towards the east side of the school. The wall guards the school on the east side to both A and B blocks in the school. The compound wall that's towards the south of the school campus. The compound wall now begins towards the west side of the campus. The parking area of the school campus accommodates 18 buses facilitating the students to commute to the school. kindergarten students of our school enjoy the school campus in the playpen area that's specially allocated for them. Ensuring the students are fit and fine, the school ensures that they use the fitness corner for their health and fitness. The basketball court of the school ensures that the sports enthusiasts have fun and also learn through team spirit and their hard work. Cricket is a game that draws interest from students of all ages. Enabling students to pursue their interests, the students can use the cricket nets for the practice available in the school campus. Sufficing the interests of the students, of huge number of students who would like to play volleyball, the school is enabled with two volleyball courts. What we see now is court A. The assembly area of the school, where the students of both blocks A and B assemble here for day-to-day assembly, and also the stage has been a hub of activity for all the major events the school covers. The assembly area too caters the kindergarten students. The assembly area too caters the pre-primary students of the school. The school also has playpen area too for the kindergarten students. What you see is the volleyball ground too for the senior block students. The amphitheater of the school stages the creative inputs from the students. The ground is also used for playing the indigenous sports like coco. Here is the tennis court of our school. As per SOP, we have three separate labs for chemistry, physics, biology and a composite labs. 6 to 8 classes have one period allotted for in the timetables for the labs. Two block periods are allotted for 9th and 10th classes. We are here in the chemistry lab now. The issue register, the inventory register, the stock verification details, and the stock register, the project files of the students of class 10 are put up here on the table. The apparatus used in the lab is here on display with labels attached. the practical files have also been stacked. The consumables and non-consumables of the lab are arranged in the cupboard. The display board here clearly defines the rules and regulations to be followed in the laboratory, culminated as the laboratory discipline board. All the labs of the school are also equipped with medical first aid kits. The first aid kit for the students in the chemistry lab. All the labs are equipped with fire extinguishers. All the chemicals that are being used here are labeled and are safely and securely stored. The students are given timely and repeated instructions to be careful while handling the chemicals and equipment in the laboratory. We are in the physics lab now. the stock verification book, the issue register of reference books, and the stock register of physics lab are here on display. The practical files and the project reports submitted by the students are also here put up on the table. The project files and the practical files of class 10 students are here on display. As per SOP, the apparatus and the equipment needed for the students to perform their experiments are also put up on the table. The charts required for the reference for the senior secondary students and the reference books are also available in the labs. The charts required for the understanding of the students and the reference books have also been stacked. The reference books also constitute of the NCERT textbooks and also other books that the students need. The practical files have also been stacked in the cupboards that are being displayed. We are moving into the biology lab now. Biology practicals are given special consideration as they are necessary to stimulate creativity, curiosity, and critical thinking among students. Here, the students would use the microscopes to view the permanent slides of the structures. The models here are also for display for the better understanding of the concepts.
Biology practicals are given special consideration as they are necessary to stimulate creativity, curiosity, and critical thinking among students.
Here on the table are the specimens for advanced understanding of the students and to enhance their critical thinking. The specimens have also been labeled for the reference of the students. the plant meiosis and mitosis models are also here for the students' reference. The students' practical records, project works, and the stock registers are put up on the table. What we see now is the workstation of the biology lab. Now we are entering into the biology ante room. The ante room is equipped with the models and charts . These are the models and charts and the list of consumables have been stacked in this room. The apparatus used and the children's work have also been piled here. The lab rules and regulations have clearly been defined for maintaining the discipline of the lab. The general instructions and the instructions while performing the experiments in the lab have also been detailed with clarity. Now we are entering the composite lab. Laboratories aim to create opportunities to provide students with hands-on experience of laboratory experiments, which could bridge the gap between theoretical concepts and their application in everyday life. Practicals enable students to connect to other science areas, communicate the information effectively, and argue their conclusions logically. The practical records have been piled up here for the reference. The items, the apparatus on display on the table are labeled for the understanding of the students. Classes 6 to 10 use the composite labs for the practical purposes in all the subjects. The art integrated project done by the students have been put up on the table. The models and charts The charts and models have been designed by the students. The charts here have been displayed for the better and effective understanding of the students of the concepts learned. a plan for the classes to be taken in the lab for classes 6 to 10 have been put up on the display board as the timetable. The students here have shown us their creativity in designing these models using best, making best out of the waste. We are now moving into the computer lab. We have around 22 computers, assuring that the students learn maximum and benefit from the infrastructure available in the school. The students have designated periods in their timetable for in which they come to the labs and use the systems, writing codes and decoding the technology. Students gleam with enthusiasm as they step into the computer labs, as they discover themselves in a completely different arena. Book, the stock verification book, the department books, AI projects, and the art integrated projects that the students have submitted from grade 10 and 12 are put up on display. Now we enter the computer lab of Block A. The lab is well facilitated with around 2 lab, as you see, is also equipped with a projector for the better understanding of the students. Ready? We are now moving into the language lab of Block B. The school library is the storehouse of knowledge. Welcome to the school library. The newspaper stand here has books, has newspapers from regional and national dailies. The periodical stand caters to varied subjects of sufficing the needs of students of varied interests. The library has around 14,000 books with 25 to 15 varieties of magazines, journals and newspapers. library is equipped with a number of reference books for the students to enhance their knowledge of their particular interests. It also has novels on different genres that the book readers would love to read. The B block has three floors and each floor has separate washrooms for boys and girls. We are now heading to washrooms, a girl's washroom in the first floor in B block. The school has six water purifiers installed in each floor for the students to use. The fire safety equipment, as you see, are well placed in both Block A and Block B. The school is well equipped with fire safety equipment. It also hosts mock fire drills annually for the benefit of the students. These are the classrooms that we have for upgradation to the coming up sections. We are now entering into the room 2. We are now getting into the third room. Room 4. With students around, emergencies come uninvited. To facilitate and attend the emergencies that are not foreseen. The school also has the school wellness room, wherein the first aid will be provided to the students who are ill. The school auditorium is a hub of activity. The major events of the school are covered here. The art exhibition that we recently have, the portraits of the paintings made by students and the pictures are still in display. Our students of the school are trained by our gymnastics. We have the springboard, the beam, and the floor mattresses for the convenience of the students. The school also houses indoor activities where the students come to play table tennis, carom board, and chess in allocated periods on regular basis. The documents required as per the CBSE norms have been put up on the table here.